Alright, hello! Chatzu here, and I am going to turn the volume down a little bit on my end. I got a little loud. There we go, 50%. That works. Nice even number. As of the recording of this video, I had just finished, was it last night? Yeah, it was last night. I just finished playing Gears of War. Those videos, more to come. But anyway, I was wondering what I'm going to play next, and then all of a sudden I open up Steam, and wouldn't you know it, there's now this little play next thing where it's just games that I have, and I'm like, you know what, I could just turn that into a series and just try out games that, at least according to Steam, I've never played, that I own. I think most people have games like that on their Steam library. Although this game, technically, I have played a little bit of it before. That was on my old computer, though, and I think I got past the tutorial and it just crashed on me and I just never opened it back up again. So, yeah, I'm going to attempt to play this with mouse and keyboard. We'll see how well that goes, but I got the controller plugged in so I can instantly switch to that just in case. Here we go. New game. Going to go with easy. Oh, I might want to turn out my light. Stephen King once wrote that's better. Nightmares exist outside of logic, and there's little fun to be had in explanations. They're antithetical to the poetry of fear. In a horror story, the victim keeps asking why, but there can be no explanation, and there shouldn't be one. The unanswered mystery is what stays with us the longest, and it's what we'll remember in the end. My name is Alan Wake. I'm a writer.
I tried writing, but oh man, I didn't like the writing part.
I've always had a vivid imagination, but this dream unsettled me. It was wild and dark and weird, even by my standards. So yes, it began with a dream.
Hello?
Following a typical nightmare pattern, I was late, desperately trying to reach my destination, a lighthouse. For some urgent reason, I couldn't remember. I'd been driving too fast down a coastal road to get there.
Alrighty then.
Hitchhiker too late.
Well, that's kind of his fault for being in the middle of the road.
He was dead. I was convinced they put me in jail and I would never see Alice again.
Shoot, I'd be like, oh, thank God. There can't be a murder if there's no body.
I was in shock from the crash.
Alright. Oh, where's my keys? Okay, there. Oh, I'm not in control yet. Oh, am I? Oh, there we go. No. Okay. Not the greatest sensitivity, but it's doable. What is this? Copies of my book? How did the trunk come open from that? What is it? My book's literally called Alan Wake.
I had to go to the lighthouse. I knew there was something important waiting for me there.
I tried to sprint. Oh, no. Ooh. I'm going to switch keyboards real quick. What I'm using is not very good for gaming. Give me just a second. Hi! Keyboard falling on my foot? Technical problems. What do you expect from this channel? Wouldn't be a Chatzu video without me screwing shit up. Okay. Oh, this is... Maybe that'll work. Ah, it's better. Yes, I see the lighthouse. But what's over here?
The bridge had collapsed. I'd have to find another way to the lighthouse.
The bridge is out! Oh, what was that? No, so if I continue any of the games that I play in this series, I'll probably just wind up using them for background footage and other videos. Hello. Whoa!
You don't even recognize me, do you, Ryder? You think you're God? You think you can just make up stuff? Play with people's lives and
oh,
you're in this story.
Whee! God, it's like every nightmare I've ever had. Oh, space to jump.
You missed your deadline. Damn. You can't stop me.
Oh, I'm trying this with the controller. Oh my god. Okay, jump. What sprint?
To die by the hands of your own.
Oh boy. Oh, thank you. Why is that not working? Oh, there we go. Oh, that's an awkward button for that, but... not as awkward as what I was dealing with. Uh-oh. I'm coming! I can't, I'm out of sprint! You ain't gotta tell me twice. Oh.
Oh no.
Man, that volume is loud.
Stop. No! Damn it, die! No! No! No!
You wanna dodge, buddy? Alright, lesson learned. When someone is swinging an axe at you, don't just stand there like a jackass. Creepy. What is this? Something of fate. Oh, jeez.
The cabin was a death trap. I had to get out.
How? Oh, okay.
Follow the light.
Okay, I'll go into the light, I guess.
You are hurt. You should go into the light. You are only safe there.
Run. I have something important to tell you. It goes like this. For he did not know that beyond the lake he called home lies a deeper, darker ocean green, where waves are both wilder and more serene. To its ports I've been. To its ports I've been. Do you understand?
No.
My thoughts exactly.
I entered your dream to teach you. The darkness is dangerous. It's sleeping now.
Alrighty then.
It will wake up. There's no time. I can only show you the most important thing. The hitchhiker has been taken over by the dark presence. You can't hurt him now. The darkness protects him from all harm. Only light can drive the darkness away and make him vulnerable again. Here, take the light.
Come on.
Pick up the flashlight.
Okay, Jesus.
Turn your flashlight toward him and burn the darkness away.
Okay, there we go.
You did it. Now the darkness no longer protects him, but it's still inside, controlling him. He can't be saved. He's still a threat. He is still your enemy. Here, take the gun.
Alright.
Now you'll see.
Woohoo! Do I get more ammo? Yes.
Good. You've done well. Remember what I've taught you. That is all. I will give you back your dream now.
In the nightmare, a terrible darkness was taking over the world. The lighthouse was the last safe place on Earth.
It's been a few years. I only vaguely remember this opening. Oh, limit reached. Okay. Probably said that before. I just wasn't paying enough attention. Woo! Max Payne style, motherfucker! Oh, jeez. Hell no, I want the revolver. Jeez. There we go. I'm just gonna run. Oof.
I can keep this up
forever. Oh. Alrighty. Oh boy. I will risk my life for some coffee. And I think most of you would do the same. Right.
Alan, wake up.
See, I think that's into the dream.
Baby, just another nightmare. Everything's fine. He dozed off.
See, it was either during this cutscene or right after it that it crashed. For everyone.
Cheer up, handsome. We're here.
Yeah, I remember this. I remember. Remember Max Payne? I remember. Okay. Yeah, I never got to this part.
Let's act like we're on vacation. Go stand next to that old gentleman there. I want a shot of you with a crown in the background.
Sure. I'll even give you a title for the shot. A city boy. Moments before he got eaten by a bear. Hi.
Hello there. You picked a good time to visit our town. Deerfest is just 2 weeks away.
Deerfest, huh? Did you hear that, honey?
Huh.
You have a lovely wife. If you don't mind me saying, I'm Pat Mayne, by the way.
Nice no, only if you don't mind me punching you over that rail.
I won't pretend I don't recognize a famous writer such as yourself, Mr. Wake. A pleasure. I'm an avid reader myself. I hope this isn't too presumptuous of me, but
I gotta start reading again.
The local radio station. Any chance I could get an interview?
Look, Mr. Mayne, I'm on vacation.
It's probably what I'm gonna do after this.
I'd appreciate it if we could keep my being here just between the two of us. I'm sure you understand.
Can you keep a secret, old man?
Trust me.
Remember, over the rail.
Hard man to track down if you change your mind, though. I hope you two have a lovely holiday.
You live for now.
Very nice. I got a couple of really good ones. And I've seen you made a friend. That's cute.
Right. Yeah?
Hey, bestseller. How's my favorite writer? Are you there yet?
Barry. Yeah. We just got him.
Are the locals giving you trouble? Just say the word and I'll hop on a plane and come make sure that you're left alone, Al.
No, Barry. We're fine.
Great. Great. Just want to make sure you can relax and recharge. So, how is the place? Has it gotten your creative juices flowing?
Barry, we're just settling in.
Okay, Al. Yuppies. I'll call back later to make sure you're doing okay. And you call me if there's...
Send you over the rail, too.
Okay?
I love you too, Barry.
Loving the water effects.
Barry is Barry. I can always turn off the phone.
What did I tell you?
Text message from Barry. He says hi to you too.
Alan, we're here. Come on, let's get back to the car.
Alright.
We need to stop at the local diner to get the cabin key from the landlord. A Mr. Carl Stuckey. He's waiting for us.
Ah, diner. As if this couldn't get any more Twin Peaks.
Before you get the key. I'll pick you up here in, say, 15 minutes?
Sure.
I also need to rewatch that show.
Thank you for coming here with me.
I love you, too. Go on. I'll promise to behave.
Nothing like just watching Twin Peaks and pretending like you get it.
Like this. Towns where everybody knew everybody.
Welcome to the O'Dear Diner.
Hi, I was wondering if you could help me. I'm looking for...
Mr. Wake. Alan Wake. Oh, God! I am your biggest
creepy
fan.
Face.
I know people say that all the time, but I really am.
I'm glad to hear that.
Rose.
Rose, I'm looking for Mr. Stuckey. Carl Stuckey?
Carl? Of course, Mr. Wake. He must have gone to visit the restroom. He'll be back in a moment. I can't believe
to visit the restroom? Is it lonely?
I got the cut up from the bookstore when they took it out of the window.
And to keep it here. Well, okay.
You don't look good suspicious at all. And he's running like he's got a poop.
Just don't blame me when you fall in love, because it'll break your heart when you have to leave.
Rusty here is no longer human.
Right.
Nothing but
so
black
much for
coffee
quiet
under a thin layer of skin.
Yeah, that makes two of us.
That is just straight up Max Payne looking.
there, Sonny. I could really use a tune right now. Coconut, number 6 in the jukebox. I'd do it myself, but both of my legs have gone to sleep. Bad circulation. Yeah.
Are you serious? Coconut again? You disgust me. Call yourself a rocker. Unbelievable.
It does that. Get stuck. Yeah. You need to give it a good solid whack.
Now, I already did.
What I'm talking about. Yes.
This is it. I've died and gone to hell.
Oh. Goodness. Supposed to be like log lady? It's lamp lady. I love it. Oh. Ominous.
Don't go in there, gentlemen. You can hurt yourself in the dark.
I think I can handle it, ma'am.
I didn't want to wait. I wanted to find Stucky to get the key and get out as soon as possible.
I don't need sleep. I need answers.
Hello? Mr. Stucky?
Carl couldn't make it, unfortunately.
Creepy.
But I have the key for you and instructions on how to get to the lake.
Okay.
I wish you a good stay in my cabin. I'll come by later to check how you've settled in. And to meet your wife. I insist.
Thanks.
I know the first person I'm gonna punch, but I also don't want to go near you.
Very inspiring.
I'm inspired to punch you in the face!
You got lucky this time, young man. You can hurt yourself in the dark. This really ought to be fixed, and then I must be from my cell. I can change the...
Even that sounds better than your singing.
Are you alright?
Andersons. They're local musicians. We're waiting for Dr. Hartman to come pick them up. They wandered off from his clinic at the Cauldron Lake Lodge.
You can't see it, but I'm bobbing my head to the music.
Bye, Mr. Wake.
Mission accomplished. The key and the directions.
My hero. I got some flashlights, just in case.
Hey, wait! Mrs. Wake! Your keys!
Huh.
That diner was a real nut house.
Can you believe this place? This would make a wonderful setting for a book.
We're supposed to be on vacation.
Or a video game.
I'll figure it out when we get back home. Okay?
Okay. We can talk about this later.
Batman here on PBF Heaven.
I didn't want to talk about it. I wanted to bury my head in sand.
Here's another one of my favorites to go with it.
Once upon a time, I was a successful writer, but that was a long time ago. I hadn't been able to write a word in 2 years, not since my last book.
Oh, I feel that. I feel that in my bones. Looks like it'd be a lovely place to quarantine.
It's something, all right.
Anything back here to grab?
I'll get inside safe and sound before it gets dark. And I've got the flashlight.
Oh.
I know. I'm okay.
Alice had a phobia. Uh-oh. A fear of darkness. I wanted to make sure we were inside
ends.
With the lights on before sunset.
I'll do what I want. Go to cabin. Oh, well, unlike on the console, I don't have a little timer to see how long I've been playing, so I'm just
Gonna play till I don't feel like playing. Why the hell not? Oh. Ha-ha! I came all this way for a coffee!
The cabin obviously got its name from the shape of the island. It looked like a giant bird leg. Alice had mentioned that the lake was a caldera. There was a dormant volcano under it.
Kind of looks like Godzilla's footprints on the 98 film. Although without the back toe. You know, I don't hate that movie. I mean, I'm not going to pretend like it's good or anything, but everybody likes to make fun of the special effects. I'm like, shit, I thought they looked great at the time. Yeah, they're dated now. Crow, or Raven, or whatever. Whatever reference you're trying to make, game. Oh, wow, a lot of them. Always gotta explore. Look for goodies. Oh. Fuck it, am I able to? No. Invisible wall. Oh, creepy bat cabin. Generator. Makes sense.
Alice had told me about Calder Lake Lodge.
Oh, wow.
The old building used to be a hotel, but these days it was no longer open to the public.
Can you say Shining reference? Or, I don't know, maybe that's a Twin Peaks reference. Maybe it's both. That's what I could do. After this, I can start reading a Stephen King book.
Let's take a look inside.
It's dark in there. We need light. Can you figure out how to get the power on, honey?
A shoebox filled with books by Thomas Zane sat on the shelf. I'd never heard of him before.
Hello? Anyone here?
Yoink. I'm gonna assume coffee's health. It's a nice cabin.
For a moment, the oppressive feel of the nightmare I had seen on the ferry returned.
Whoa! Okay.
I needed to get the power running in the cabin. There had to be a fuse box or a generator somewhere on the island. The cabin looked like a time capsule from the 60s, or even earlier.
Or even later? I like it. Wait. No fridge.
No, thank you. Ah.
But your best guests have already started to arrive. Just ran into one on the ferry. Famous artist, no less. We'll see if we can rope him into an interview later on. Now let's go.
Water was clear but dark. It looked very deep.
It actually does. Very good art direction in this game. Wait a second, is that? Oh, never mind. Thought I recognized the song.
The power cable goes to that shed over there.
Yeah, I know. I didn't see a door, though. Oh, there it is. Thought that was a door. Okay. Oh, there's a door.
An old generator had been connected
to
the
power cable. I'm blind. Okay. I get it. Let there be light. I don't even know if you can see the achievements on here. It'd probably show up. Thanks for doing nothing.
The island had...
Really?
It was a beautiful place. I told myself I could rest here, sleep here, and forget about my work.
Oh, I could live there. That looks beautiful.
I thought we could be happy here.
I mean, I know things are gonna go to shit, but...
Maybe it would be that again.
Okay, and it just finished up the audio, but I forgot what he was saying.
Alice? Honey?
Alan, I'm upstairs. I have a surprise for you.
Well,
okay.
Hello. I'm not the surprise. It's in the study. Go take a look.
Okay.
Freaking cock tease. Is this what she's talking about?
Surprise!
Oh.
Alice? What is this?
I guess I have a small confession to make. I thought maybe you could write here, that a change of scenery would get you past...
Dad, Alice, you... Everyone
keeps... Hey! Just hear me out! There's a local doctor, Dr. Hartman. I read a book of his. He has a private clinic here. He specializes in helping artists.
So now you want to get me committed?
No! It's not like that! That's not...
Whoa!
Alan?
I don't! Just don't! I don't want to hear it! God damn it, Alice!
All work and no play make Alan a dull boy!
I knew she wouldn't follow me in the dark. I needed some time alone to think things through.
Whoa.
Alice!
It was dark. All the lights were out.
Alice! Where are
What the hell?
Oh, she dead.
Oh no.
Woo. I'll save you with the power of the Matrix.
Keep going.
Huh.
Waking up in the crashed car felt like I had woken from one nightmare and entered another. I couldn't remember how I got there. All I knew was that something terrible had happened to Alice. The phone was dead.
She made her way to Wonderland.
I have to find help on foot.
My God, she'll never come back.
Among Alice's things was a book, The Creator's Dilemma, by a Dr. Emil Hartman. Seeing the book brought back my fight with Alice. I didn't like it.
What, the one that happened 2 seconds ago?
A smug face on the cover, either.
Alrighty then. Here we go.
The gas station was my best bet. They'd have a phone I could use. It looked like a long hike through the forest to get there.
Let's go hiking.
Damn.
I'm sure the insurance will cover that. I don't want to waste my sprint. Oh hell, what the hell. The light.
Hello? Someone there?
Huh.
The loose sheets of paper were pages from a manuscript entitled Departure. That was the name I planned to use for the next novel I had never gotten started. I was named the author. I hadn't written it. I couldn't remember writing it. In the scene on the page, the hero was attacked by an axe murderer in the woods at night.
Uh-oh. Reach the gas station. How about mission objective? Don't fucking die. Not yet, you haven't been.
The lights up ahead were a good sign. Maybe I wouldn't have to hike all the way down to the gas station to find a phone.
Then. Whee.
Anybody there? Oof. Please, I've been in an accident. Hey! Hey, you!
Phil!
There's been an accident. I need help.
Deposit.
I need to...
Many cabins for rent in...
Nightfall!
Oh, hell.
Carl... Ducky, to make your non-refundable
reservation
as required, fair and square.
Square.
Stucky, where'd you go, Stucky? Oh. Bullshit! Here's Stucky.
Any second now, and Stucky would be knocking on the door with his axe like Nicholson in The Shining.
Ah! Called it! Jumping.
Outside a shooting range, and now I just killed someone or something. There were no bodies, they just disappeared. I was dreaming, it felt real enough to make me sick. The dark forest was the last place I wanted to go, but I had no choice. I had to get to the gas station.
It's rabbit season.
What the heck? Okay, fine, I'll fight him. Jesus. Oh.
What the hell was that? When I saw the river below, something uncoiled itself inside my head. I realized that I'd have to find a way across. I didn't even want to look at the water.
Huh. Okay.
Stucky was still out there, in the dark, stalking me.
Yay! Oh. Sorry, itch. Interesting stuff over here. No? Okay. Moving on.
The staircase was broken.
Oh, crap.
I had to make my way up some other way.
All right.
roundabout way it is.
There was no power. There was bound to be a generator somewhere at the logging site.
Oh, I don't like this. Oh, God. Before I do that, though, oh, yes, please. Oh, not yet. Wait for more ammo. Before I do that, though, coffee, coffee, coffee. All right. I am enjoying the hell out of this game so far. Really? I guess I gotta jump. Jump. Checkpoint. I didn't say switch.
I'm a night owl, and it's on nights like this I wish I wasn't cooped up in the studio. Makes an old man like me just like a big roam wild. But here I am.
Gold? Another page.
The gas station was closer now, its light welcoming in the darkness.
The best dogs in the street. Belly Burster is the best with no coat. Burster dog is
thank you.
Woo! I'm going the right direction.
Oh God! Oh, jeez. Okay. Oh, reload, hello. Yoink. All right. So then where am I supposed to be going, or was that it? Okay, yeah, that's it. Where's he at? Oh, that's just all kinds of creepy. I'm gonna run for it. Oh, jeez! Jeez! Creepy stuff we got on here. Immortality on those who advance it to elevate all of mankind. Newton, Einstein, Sagan, princes among the men. But the price for such a legacy is steep indeed. Night springs. Tonight's episode, quantum suicide. If our lives are already written, it would take a courageous man to
This is what I'm talking about.
There is no risk. Observe what occurs when I place the weapon against my own forehead. Now, you might think this round is merely a dud. Not so. Observe the flower pot. And yet,
alrighty.
Cannot be harmed with this gun. With each pull of the trigger, two new...
Pretty sure that's not how that works.
Circumstances, can this gun kill me?
So wait. What you're saying is that every time you pull the trigger, in another reality, you die?
Yes, of course, but that's completely trivial. There's an infinite number of things that could happen at any moment, and they always do happen somewhere. The point is, this one thing did not...
Uh-oh, SpaghettiOs. Okay. Also, note to self, just fight him, no matter what. I don't like how many places there are for them to hide. Fun little encounter. points, if this goes on for too long, I can always just split it up into multiple episodes. Yay for the power of editing.
I recognize the parade float I had seen in Bright Falls when I first arrived with Alice. After the insanity I had just experienced in the darkness, the lights of the gas station felt comforting. At least for a moment, the sane world reasserted
itself. That's why I immediately went into the darkness.
The Deer Fest had been 2 weeks away when we arrived. If the day count on the banner was right, I was missing a whole week between the night we got here and now. The garage was a mess. It looked like someone had trashed the place, or that there'd been some kind of fight.
Outside, there's only darkness. Outside the cabin, outside the store, there's only darkness.
Huh.
I can feel a presence in the dark. Just now, I could smell a perfume in the room. I'll reach her, I'll fix her. I'll bring her back. The story will come true. If I stop, she's lost.
I don't believe this. It'd been me on the TV, talking crazy.
I noticed.
Was I losing my mind?
Alright, 68th Annual Deer Fest, September 15th to 18th. Games and activities, raffle tickets, fishing competition, pie contest, and surprise competitions. Live music for the children, Bucktooth Charlie, Afternoons, Montgomery, The Mystic Amazing, Phantasmagoria, Evenings. Don't miss the legendary Deer Fest Parade. There's seriously nothing else in here. Oh, coffee? Water? Ah, phone.
Bright Falls Sheriff Station.
Thought it froze on me for a second there.
Oh, thank God, Sheriff.
Sheriff Sarah Breaker, you are...
I'm Alan Wake, but listen, I was in a car crash. My wife, Alice, she's missing.
Calm down, Mr. Wake.
We were staying in a cabin on the island, on Cauldron Lake.
There's no island on Cauldron Lake, not since the big eruption in the 70s.
Please, I can take you there, okay?
You look like you've taken a pretty bad knock to the head. Are you okay?
Listen.
We'll figure this out. Please get in the car. We'll swing by the lake and then we'll go to the station, okay? Mr. Wake, have you seen Stucky, the guy who owns this place?
I couldn't tell her what had happened in the forest. She wouldn't have believed me. And then she wouldn't have helped me with Alice.
You're in a bit of a predicament, buddy. Alrighty. That's Bucktooth. Doofy face.
Just a sprinkle of stardust and a whisper. Go to sleep, everything is alright. I close my eyes.
Like, no, I ain't gonna skip.
Into the magic night.
I'll just talk over it so it doesn't get copyright struck.
A silent prayer.
nodding my head to the beat. Hope you're enjoying this as much as I am. But no, that's seriously a perfect place to stop this once it's over. It's my jam right here. How many episodes there are. Still nodding to the beat. Hell, even if it gets copyright struck, it'll still be on BitChute. Or once again, wherever else I decide to upload this. Just for future proofing. Ah. Loving it. Aww. Is it gonna go ahead? Or, okay.
Previously on Alan Wake.
Are you serious?
I came to Bright Falls with my wife, Alice.
Thank you for coming here with me. I thought maybe you could write here.
I don't want to hear
it. Straight up Twin Peaks. I know kung fu.
Of a crashed car. I'm missing a week. I was attacked by shadowy men straight from a nightmare. The sheriff took me to the lake Alice and I had stayed at, but the cabin had disappeared.
What a twist! Episode 2 taken. New York City 3 years ago.
Weather I've ever seen.
You should put some coffee on. It'll warm you up.
Oh, man. So, yeah, that was good. Matter of fact, just gonna alt-tab this, because it ain't just gonna cut out like it does when I'm using Twitch. But yeah, so that's, a taste of Alan Wake. ooh, excuse me. Must have the Rona. But anyway, yeah, if that, if this looks like something you'd be interested in, I think, let me actually look at GOG real quick, because if I'm not mistaken, it is on sale as of the recording of this video. I think. Yeah, why the hell not? I'll upload it tonight. Oh yeah, $1.49 on GOG right now. I've got the Steam version. Shoot, I might just buy the GOG version. Why the hell not? But yeah, that is that's gonna be the end of this little, well, the end of the first episode of this little experiment, and see you in the next one. This is Chatzu signing out.